Hello learners, I am Dr. Neetu Shukla and I am here with you to take a session about the World Education Forum, Dakar, Senegal 2000. This event was organized by the International Consultative Forum on Education for All, also known as the EFA Forum, a body created in 1991 to monitor Education for All post-Thomsian Conference in 1990. It composed of representatives of the five international agencies that sponsored the initiative: UNESCO, UNICEF, UNDP, UNFPA, and the World Bank, and of bilateral cooperation agencies, governments and NGOs, as well as by some education specialists. The purpose of the forum was to present the global results of the evaluation of the decade of Education for All launched in Thomsian, Thailand, in March 1990, and to adopt a new framework for action, essentially in order to continue the task. The representatives from 155 countries and 150 organizations participated and pledged to provide education for all by the year 2015 at this World Conference on Education for All, reaffirming the vision of World Declaration on Education for All adopted 10 years earlier, Thomsian in Thailand, 1990. The report of UNESCO of the International Commission on Education for the 21st century promoted a view of education crossing consisting of four pillars of education, which need to be kept in context when we are talking about education for all. These four pillars were learning to know, learning to do, learning to be, and learning to live together. The meeting in Dhaka, the participants committed themselves to the achievement of education for all, goals and targets for every citizen and for every society. The education for all goals were: number one, expanding and improving comprehensive early childhood care and education, especially for the most vulnerable and disadvantaged children. Second objective was to ensure that by 2015, all children, particularly girls, children in difficult circumstances, and those belonging to ethnic minorities have access to and complete free and compulsory primary education of good quality. The third aim was to ensure that the learning needs of all young people and adults are met through equitable access to appropriate learning and life skills program. You must note here that life skills are very important and significant for education for all. Next, achieving a 50% improvement in levels of adult literacy by 2015, especially for women, and equitable access to basic and continuing education for all adults. The next objective was eliminating gender disparity in primary and secondary education by 2005. And achieving gender equality in education by 2015. With a focus on ensuring girls' full and equal access to and achievement in basic education of good quality, improving all aspects of the quality of education and ensuring excellence of all so that recognized and measurable learning outcomes are achieved by all, especially in literacy, numeracy, and essential life skills. For when we talk about education for all, it doesn't mean that everybody is enrolled and everybody has access to school. It also means that everybody achieves and they succeed. The aims of World Education Forum were to mobilize strong national and international political commitment for education for all, develop national action plans, and enhance significantly investment in basic education. Here we should remind ourselves that in the Thomsian Conference 10 years back, the same effort was called for. But when the assessment was done, it was found that many countries were lagging behind in the realization of these goals. Hence, once again, the Dhaka framework is stated that we should mobilize strong national and international political commitment for education for all. And there is a need that each country develop national action plans and enhance significant investment in basic education. Next, to promote EFA policies within a sustainable and well-integrated sector framework, clearly linked to poverty elimination and development strategies. We should remind here ourselves of the fact that education for all aimed not just for educating people, but it was in fact aiming for a very higher goal of human development. And when we talk about human development, sustainable and well-integrated support framework is required so that poverty is eliminated and developmental strategies take their due course of time. To meet the needs of education systems affected by conflict, national calamities and instability and conduct educational programs. All over the world, violence has been pervading everywhere, and because of which many countries have not been able to realize their goals of education for all. So, in this forum, it was realized that such countries which are affected by conflict, some kind of war situation, some kind of disturbance, maybe there was a tsunami, maybe there was an earthquake, which led to national calamities and instability, their special effort has to be made by the national agencies as well as international agencies by conducting educational programs in ways that promote mutual understanding, peace and tolerance and help to prevent violence and conflict. Because when we talk about sustainable development, we want development of all. A development which will take us forward and not backward. Something which will promote all of us and will not annihilate anybody. To implement integrated strategies for gender equality in education, which recognize the need for changes in attitudes, values and practices. Of the many reasons which were identified for the non-fulfillment of EFA, one reason was that people, communities were yet not prepared and ready for implementing the strategies of education for all in the right spirit. This required for a change in attitudes, values and practices. Hence, in this framework, it was stressed that the objective and the goal should be to implement integrated strategies for gender equality in education, which recognize the need for changes in attitudes, values and practices. Implement, as a matter of urgency, education programs and actions to combat the HIV/AIDS. The world is growing fast at a huge pace. In our country itself, the number of adolescents is on the rise. And with this, a number of challenges are also coming up. It's very essential that issues such as HIV, AIDS and all these are discussed and programs are launched for the target group so that they are able to contribute their own part in a sustainable development of this world. To enhance the status, morale and professionalism of teachers. For we all know that if the teachers are not motivated, if they are not satisfied, how can we expect them to deliver that satisfaction, that motivation to their learners? Hence, it's mandatory that all the national agencies and the international agencies, they make efforts to enhance the status, the morale and professionalism of teachers. The world is changing, technology is coming in. Thus, it's urgent that we harness this new information and communication technologies to help achieve education for all. Systematically monitor progress towards education for all goals and strategies at the national, regional and international levels. It's said that we are able to make plans very well, but when it comes to implementation, that's where all our plans fail. The primary reason behind this is that the monitoring is not happening properly. Hence, the DACA framework once again stressed that monitoring should be done so that the goals are achieved, the strategies are implemented in the right spirit and they are able to deliver their goals, both at the national, regional and international levels. What can be achieved through strong national strategies supported by effective development cooperation, progress must be accelerated through increased international support. This point needs to be underlined that international support has to be there. In the framework for action, it is reiterated that there is an emphasis on the need for participatory mechanisms and processes within each country in order to design, implement and monitor these national plans. Once the plans are made, once the national level policies are executed, it is important that a participatory mechanism is launched where the community is involved in the manifestation and implementation of all the processes and the strategies. The processes within each country, they need to be implemented in the right spirit and they need to be monitored as well. It is said in the framework that the heart of education for all activity lies at the country level. National Education for All forums will be strengthened or established to support the achievement of education for all. Thus, in this framework, they once again stated that the national forums have to be strengthened to support the achievement of EFA. All relevant ministries and national civil society organizations will be systematically represented in these forums. They should be transparent and democratic and should constitute a framework for implementation at sub-national levels. For unless and until this monitoring is done, the goals are far to be achieved. The countries with less developed strategies must be given the support they need to achieve more rapid progress towards education for all. The participant countries will strengthen accountable international and national mechanisms. To give clear expression to these commitments and to ensure that the DACA framework for action is on the agenda of every international and regional organization, every national legislature and every local decision-making forum. So what has been observed that in the DACA framework, for the first time it was said that the community involvement, the national involvement has to be more. The Education for All 2000 assessment highlights that the challenge of education for all is greatest in sub-Saharan Africa, in South Asia and in the least developed countries. Implementation of the preceding goals and strategies will require national, regional and international mechanisms to be galvanized immediately. National Education for All forums will be strengthened or established to support the achievement of education for all. For those countries with significant challenges such as complex crisis or natural disasters, special technical support will be provided. National delegations left DACA with the task of organizing in the immediate future National Education for All forums and drawing up in a participatory manner National Education for All plans by 2002. So, the goals of the World Conference were too ambitious, no doubt, but they are worth striving for. Every nation must own the responsibility and come out with a realistic plan of action for achieving the objectives as per their needs and requirement. International cooperation and commitment to this objective must be sought, must be honored and put into effect. The program was organized in plenary sessions, broad policy issues and strategy sessions, key operational issues, linked with the theme of each plenary. During the plenary session, some of the themes were improving the quality and equity of education for all, making effective use of resources for education, cooperating with civil society to achieve social goals through education, promoting education for democracy and citizenship, fulfilling our shared commitment to education for all, establishing the new partnership for education for all. During the sub-plenary sessions, the themes explored were technology for basic education, a luxury or a necessity, overcoming obstacles in the education of girls, overcoming the effects of HIV/AIDS on basic education, fighting poverty and marginalization through broad education. During the strategy session, some of the themes explored were meeting special and diverse education needs, making inclusive education a reality, universalizing free and compulsory primary education, expanding access to early childhood development programs, designing basic education content to meet the needs and values of society, assessing learning achievement, enabling teachers to enable learners, utilizing debt relief for education, working with the business community to strengthen basic education, strategic choices in development and use of teaching and learning resources, providing basic education in situations of emergency and crisis, monitoring the provision and outcomes of basic education, mobilizing new resources for basic education, building effective partnerships with funding agencies, promoting population and reproductive health, especially among young people through basic education, building social integration through bilingual and mother tongue education. It is very essential that when we are aiming for education for all, we want to reach out to each and every quarter, each and every corner of a nation. We have to ensure that the basic education which is being imparted is given in the language of the child, that is, the mother tongue, hence the emphasis on bilingual education. A fresh start to school health, improving learning and educational outcomes by improving health, hygiene and nutrition, promoting basic education and democracy, the role of the media. This is again a very significant theme which was deliberated upon, that how media is contributing to the realization of the goals of EFA, including the excluded, enhancing educational access and quality, ensuring literacy for all, a renewed vision for a 10-year global action plan, and most important, after primary education, what? The deliberations were on as to how future has to be chalked out, the future plans have to be carved out. Now, some data from Education for All 2000 regarding the global assessment. It was found that in around 60 countries which carried out learning assessment operations, only 5% of primary pupils attained or surpassed the minimum levels of learning. This shows the dismal state of education that we are imparting to our children. The figures for repetition remain extremely high. Among the causes of the low quality of education, some of them were the low salaries and poor training of teachers. Worldwide, 63% of the cost of education was found to be covered by government agencies. Only 35% was covered by the private sector, which included parents, and 2% by external cooperation. Half of the developing countries which supplied information reported spending less than 1.7% of their GNP on basic education in 1998. This shows the priority which has been assigned to education for all by various nations. Some of the challenges and opportunities which were explored during this meet were that many countries are still striving for education for all. They are still trying to meet the access needs of their learners. They are striving to define what is basic education, what content would go into the basic education. Another challenge is, what is clear is that quality must not suffer as access expands, and that improvements in quality should not benefit the economically well off. So a consensuous effort has to be made by the government of the various countries as well as other bodies who are working towards EFA, that they are able to distribute the benefits of their strategies, their policies and their other practices to the ones who really need them. Another challenge is accessing the girls' education, ensuring that being given the equal right to study, to enroll, to excel, and above all, inclusive education, trying to reach out to all the marginalized sections of the society. So, with this, we come to the end of this session. See you in the next session. Thank you.